Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fine. Today we are going to read our second chapter, The Sound of Music, which was written by Debahar Kauli. First of all, we discuss the title. The title itself is very interesting. Here the author says, Evelyn Granny listened to sound without hearing it. Now we all wonder, we are confused, how can you listen to sound when you cannot hear? So let us start the chapter. God may have taken her hearing, but she has taken her back, something extraordinary. What we hear, she feels far more deeply than any of us. That is why she expresses music so beautifully. Read the following account of a person who fought against a physical disability and made her life a success story. So someone has commented this about Evelyn. He says that although God took away her hearing power, she was impaired, but he gave her an extraordinary thing, and it was a sense of feeling, and she could feel very happy. From here we come to know that the theme of the story and the message we get from the story of Evelyn Glennon, is a motivational story. So let us start this chapter. Rush hour crowd just style for a position on the underground train platform. A slight girl looking younger than her 17 years was nerves yet excited, and she felt the vibration from the approaching train. Now the scene is of the train platform. It is underground and there is a huge rush at the platform. People people are pushing each other to get away. There is a small thin girl. It was Evelyn. Evelyn is standing at a railway platform and waiting for a train. It was her first day at the prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London, and daunting enough for a teenager fresh from a Scottish farm. But this aspiring musician faced a bigger challenge than most. She was profoundly deaf. Evelyn is 17 years of age. She is a teenager, and it is she is fresh from a Scottish farm. As Evelyn is from Scotland, which has more of farms and also countryside, so she has not seen fast life. Even Evelyn could not hear, and this was the bigger challenge for him. Moving from a rural area to a fast life was a smaller challenge. Evelyn Glennon losing hair had been gradually. The mother remembers noticing something was wrong when the 8 years old Evelyn was waiting to play piano. They called her name and she did not move. I suddenly realized that she did not hear, says Isabella Glennon. Now slowly she started losing the power of hearing, and one day she was absolutely deaf. Her mother, Miss Isabel Glennon, is the name of Elvin's mother. Elvin's mother Isabella recollects one incident when Evelyn was 8 years old. She says that Evelyn was waiting for her turn to play piano, but when her name called out, she did not respond. And her mother realized that Evelyn did not respond to her name. That means she did not hear. And after that, for a quite while, Evelyn managed to console her growing deafness from friends and teacher, but by the time she was 11, her marks had deteriorated, and her headmistress ordered her parents to take to a specialist. It was then discovered that her hearing was severely impaired as a result of gradually nerve damage. They were advised that she should be fitted with hearing aid and sent to a school for the deaf. Now when as Evelyn lost her sense of hearing in phase, it was a gradual process. In the beginning, when she could hear partially, she managed to hide this disability from her friends and teacher. When Evelyn was 11 years old, her marks had started deteriorating, and the headmistress requested her parents to take it away to the doctor. When the doctor checked upon Evelyn, he found out that Evelyn had lost his hearing sense. But Evelyn did not going to give up. She was determined to lead a normal life and pursue her interest in music. One day, she noticed a girl playing a xylophone and decided that she wanted to play it a xylophone and decided that and played too. Most of the teacher discouraged her, but percussionist Ron Phobos spotted her potential. Now, when Evelyn discovered that she could not hear, and that she would be sent to a school for deaf children, that she was not as good as normal children. Her words become colorless, it turns black. Now but Alvin did not give up. This show had Alvin had determination. Although Alvin got such a shocking news, she was determined and she did not want to give up. Alvin was passionate about music. This news also do not break her. She was determined to live like a normal people and follow her interest in music. When Alvin saw a girl playing the piano, playing the xylophone, she wanted to play it too. Now, no one had Alvin teacher discourage her because they knew that she could not hear, and hearing was an important part of music. But Ron Fowen saw that Alvin was very passionate about music, and so he decided something. Ron Fowen spotted her potential. He began tuning two large strums on a different notes. Don't listen through your ears, he would say. Try to sense it some other way. Says Alvin. Suddenly, I realized I could feel the higher drum from the waist up and the lower drum from the waist down. Forbes repeated the exercise, and soon Alvin discovered that she could sense certain notes in different parts of her body. I had learned to open my mind and body and sound and vibrations. The rest was she determination and hard work. Ron Forbes thought that he would teach Alvin to feel music. He took two large drums and turned them to a different notes. Drums are musical instruments, and he turned each drum from a different note, so the sound produced by the drums was different, so it was distinct. Both the drums made different sound. Then he told Alvin. He said, don't try to listen through your ears. He said that try to sense it to feel the music some other way. Now Ron Forbes had turned both the drums from different notes. The upper part of the body above the waist could feel the higher notes and the notes of the drum, and the lower part of her body, the part down from the waist, could feel the lower notes of drum. She never looked back from that point onwards. She tutored the United Kingdom with a youth orchestra. By the time she was 16, she had decided to make a music in her life. She auditioned from the Royal Academy of Music and scored one of the highest mark in the history of the academy. She gradually moved from the orchestral work to solo performance. At the end of her 3 years course, she was captured most of the top awards. Now, I had this is how Alvin can listen to sound through. She cannot hear, she can sense different from different parts of her body. Now, once Alvin overcome a hurdle, she starts sensing the different sounds through the different parts of her body. She progressed in her career. So Alvin toured the United Kingdom and performed with the youth orchestra. By the time Alvin reached at the age of 60, she had decided to make music her life. Evelyn gave an audition for the admission of Royal Academy of Music, and her score was the highest in the history of academy. Now, other person had scored such as high score as Alvin did. So initially Alvin performed in a group, and as she got well in her music, as she got confident, she started performing alone. She had achieved all the top awards by the time she had completed her 3 years course at the Royal Academy of Music. So students, the remaining part of this chapter we will discuss in our next video. Thank you.